brush off me. I can't use it anymore. It's getting dark, too dark to see. Feel like I'm knocking on heaven's door.
Knock, knock, knocking on heaven's door.
Repentance is sometimes the last door we decide to walk through. One year, the author Erica Brown writes, I was at an airport between Rosh Hashanah and Yom Kippur right near my gate, and a man was talking on his phone loudly and gesticulating wildly. I begged them to keep the door open. I pleaded, you don't understand. They closed the doors. They shut them. They just wouldn't let me on the flight. And maybe he was talking to his boss or a client, probably his wife. As he continued to talk, he got more and more flustered and made more excuses for being late, but the louder he got, the clearer it was that it was his fault. He just wasn't prepared. He got there late. The doors were already shut. The doors may be shut, but a door, a gate, is only a portal. The decision to walk through the door is our own. The transition is magnificently captured in this poem by Adrienne Rich called Prospective Immigrants. Please note, either you will go through this door or you will not go through. If you go through, there is always the risk of remembering your name. Things look at you doubly, and you must look back and let them happen. If you do not go through, it is possible to live worthily, to maintain your attitudes, hold your position, and to die bravely. But much will blind you, much will evade you. At what cost, who knows? The door itself makes no promises. It is only a door. The gates of heaven are only a door. There is no handbook or map, no promise or guarantee. It's just a door. The door is not a promise, but an invitation to launch an adventure and a journey whose destination involves change. We are living in a broken world, and the key to that world is in the door of compassion, Sha'ar HaRachamim, and the door of repentance, Sha'ar HaTshuva. They remain open, even as the other doors are closing. So, the traditional custom, if you can do it, is to stand the whole way through Ne'ilah. What we're going to do, but you don't have to do that if you don't want to, you can sit, take care of yourself. What we're going to do is we're going to open up the doors of the Ark. And for many people, the experience of coming, getting close with the Torah, maybe bringing somebody with you, can come alone, come with a partner, come with your family, come with a friend. And for many people, that's the moment when all of that access that we've been talking about, the ability to actually voice a desire, a yearning, a hope, a prayer, becomes possible. So we're going to open up that ark, and as long as the ark is open, we invite you to stand and to come to the Bima, basically throughout the service. We'll do it in a second. Let's let people sit as long as possible before we, all right. And so to come up this way, and then just come around, and then go down these stairs here, and just be careful. There's, you know, the wire here and there, just to make sure you don't trip. And we will begin first with a silent Amidah, our last of the day. There's this idea, a rabbi shared it with me once, but I've heard it from psychologists as well, the idea of the door handle moment. The door handle moment is at the end of your session with your therapist, where you say, actually, you know what, just one more thing before I go. Just one quick thing. Or I guess the equivalent for me might be like at Kiddush when somebody says, do you have like 30 seconds? That like 30 seconds is usually no less than an hour conversation, or it shouldn't be. But the thing is, we give short shrift to these things that are actually the most important thing. We wait until the very end to sort of mention it as if in passing. So what's your door handle conversation that as we enter the last Amidah of Yom Kippur, you know you've been waiting to think about, to pray about? And what might you do about it while you're here, this last hour? So we stand, open up the doors of the Ark. Feel free to just come on up.
Yitkadash Shemirabash V'yam lich malchute V'chayechon v'yomechon V'chayedecho bet Yisrael V'hagala v'zman kariv V'meru יש מרבה מבורך לעולם לא מהמאיה היי 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 יתברך וישתבח ותפאר ותרומם ותנשא ותדר ותעלה ותהלל שמי דקודשה בריחו Leila, Leila, in Kober Hatava Shirata, Tushbahatava Nehemata, Damiran, Bialma, Vimru, Amen. Take these moments for silent Amidav Neila. They start on page 370.
down 384.
El Nora Lila.
Yeah. Elohi Rachel v'Elohi Leah. Ha'el ha'gadol ha'gibor v'hanora. El Elyon.
Ay, 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 ay.
Gomer chazadim tovim v'kone ha'kol. V'zocher chazde avod v'imahot. U'mevig u'la livne v'nehem. Shemo be'ahava.
You know, it's really hard from up here to hear what you're doing down there. I don't know if you're like belting it out or if you're quietly listening as if I'm a cantor who needs to be listened to quietly. I hope that you're taking this time to actually just belt. The words are there on the side of the page on 385 in transliteration, and there's the choreography in this. The sound is a once a year only at Ne'ilah sound that somehow incorporates all of the other sounds of the High Holidays, bundling them up into one yearning, pleading sort of melody, and so all of us can add our voices to this.
Mi son. Chachamim unevonim. Umi lemedat mevinim. Eftecha fid v'tfila v'tachanunim. L'chalot u'l'chanen. P'nei melech malei rachamim. Ochel v'soleach. Le'avonim Zohreinu Lechaim Melech Hafetz B'chaim V'choteinu B'sefer Hachaim L'man L'cha Zer Moshia Umagen Baruch Atadonai Magen Abraham Ufoked Sarah
Amen
Ata Gibor Le'olam Maruna Nechayem Ata Rav Le'oshia Morid Hatam Mechakel chayim v'chesed Mechayim metim v'rachamim rabim Somech noflim v'rofech olim U'matir asurim Chayot meitim Baruch ata Adonai Mechaye ha-meitim
L'dor v'dor, hallelujah. V'ata kadosh yoshev tehilot Yisrael, El na shemana salach na hayom, Avor p'ki p'na hayom, Nahalalech anora v'ayom kadosh.
Open for us and for our brothers and sisters, wherever they might be.
Sha'are hora, sha'are bracha, sha'are gila, sha'are ditza, sha'are hod v'hadar, sha'are hato, sha'are zechuyo, sha'are chedva, sha'are tohora, sha'are yeshua, sha'are kapara, sha'are levto.
Good reputation. Open for us the gates of merit, the gates of delight.
Sha'arei mechila, sha'arei nechama, sha'arei selicha, sha'arei ezra, sha'arei parnasa tova, sha'arei tzedaka, sha'arei komamiyut, sha'arei refua shelema, sha'arei shalom, sha'arei tshuva.
The gates of pardon, the gates of consolation.
The gates of forgiveness, the gates of assistance, the gates of good livelihood.
The gates of righteousness, the gates of self-respect, the gates of full health.
The gates of shalom, the gates of teshuvah.
Seal us in the book of life for blessing, holiness. Connect us to you, for holiness is your essence. Let us enter your gates in holiness.
Kadosh, kadosh, kadosh.
Yeah.
Rabbi Alan Liu writes about a Hasidic rabbi, Rabbi Levi Yitzchak of Berdichev, who was famous for his chutzpah, his audacity, but specifically against God. I mean, he did it to people too, but he did not spare God. It was he who once put God on trial for failing to prevent the persecution and economic deprivation of the Jews of his day. Rabbi Yitzchak convicted God at this trial. He found God guilty of all charges. 1 year at Ni'ilah, Rabbi Levi Yitzchak declared war on God, but only as a last resort. First, he prayed, he tried prayer, and he said what he experienced was that the words were rising up toward heaven in visible waves. The gates of heaven sort of stopped closing and began to open just a little. So he decided to throw all of his energy into the vidui, the confession prayer, which is a standard feature of all Yom Kippur services, including Ni'ilah. We'll get there. He thought he saw the gates of heaven open a little bit. He thought maybe repentance would open them the rest of the way, and so he confessed all of his sins, and he saw that the cry was rising toward heaven, and the gates were getting a little wider, but not very far. So he declared war on God, the only recourse left to him. Now a tzaddik, a righteous saint like Levi Yitzchak of Berdichev, doesn't wage war the way a king or a general would wage war, and he doesn't use the same weapons either. A tzaddik employs an army of the righteous, and their weapons are their good deeds. And so his last desperate attempt to open the gates wide, he raised his head and he cried out to the heavens, "Let them speak, not me. Remember the 2 rubles that Sarah, a widow, paid her son's teacher instead of spending them on the dress that she had longed for. Remember the bowl of soup the yeshiva student shared with his classmates in spite of the fact that he was starving himself. Remember the bundle of money and the parcel of land that Reb Chaim lost because he refused to go back on his word." And so he went on and on, listing the simple acts of kindness, unselfishness, and mercy that the ordinary people in his congregation had performed in the past year. And the congregation raised their eyes, and they could all see the gates of heaven completely open, and they saw their prayers become a garland and rest on God's proverbial head as the Holy One descended from the seat of judgment and sat instead on the seat of mercy. And he describes Rabbi Liu, may his memory be a blessing. He was a rabbi in San Francisco. "At Ni'ilah, I feel as if I'm in the presence of a single trembling heart. All the thousands of gestures, the blowing of a nose, the stifling of a yawn, the wiping away of a tear, a person standing up over here and sitting down over there, a child jumping up, another crying, all of these gestures become a single gesture unfolding across the sanctuary in waves and billows. And I look down at the faces overwashed by such an innocence that it covers over everyone, and everyone becomes one suffering heart. And there comes a point where I don't think I can bear to see it anymore, the weight of the suffering in all of these faces. It just becomes too heartbreaking for me, and I feel as if I have to scream or cry or run away. And just at that moment, when I think I can't bear it one more second, I see a great light between the suffering of all of those faces, beneath the suffering, and I come and I suddenly realize what I am seeing only looks like suffering, but really all of it, the sunken skin, the lined brow, the clouded eyes, it's just the convulsions and the lines of a force of great love that it makes as it struggles to come to the surface of our lives. And I always feel then that I am standing at the head of an army of infinite power. I look from face to face. I have seen into the hearts of so many people in the room. I know that this one has lost a husband, and this one has lost a son, and this one a mother, and this one envies all of them because she has never had anyone but lived alone, longing for partnership all her life. This one had a husband but was never able to have a child, and this one lost his job, and this one has a job but it isn't much of one, and he hates it. He hates getting up in the morning, and everyone has always felt him to be a failure. And this one is a big success, but his wife is leaving him and his children are devastated. And this one has been devastated by her children. And this one has been fighting a terrible cancer that is now back with a vengeance. And her life hangs in the balance. And I look from face to face, and I know that all of these people will just go on living, day to day, as if nothing happened, quietly, heroically, complaining a little, but not nearly as much as they deserve to. They continue to hope, they continue to love, they keep going to work, taking their kids to school, coming to synagogue, and I say to myself, I would go into battle with this army any day of the week. So every year in Ne'ilah, I declare war on God. I turn the full force of our spiritual armamentarium on God, and I say, give us one more year, or else. Give us one more year of sun and rain and wind, one more year to labor and love on this roiling green and blue ball. Give me and give us one more year to love our partners and our friends and our children and our parents. One more year to watch my children grow. Promise me this or else. Promise me this while there is still a small, charged opening between heaven and earth. Give me one more year of life. Promise me this before the gates come clanging shut.
Zochreinu Adonai Eloheinu, bo letova fogdenu vo livracha. Remember us with goodness.
We can say amen.
Amen.
Provide us with blessing.
Amen.
Enable us to live.
Amen.
Have compassion on us. Help us, for our eyes are connected to you, directed to you. Ki lecha einenu, ki el melechanu nevrachum. Ata patach lanu sha'ar ve'et ni'ilat shar kifana hayom. The day is ending, the sun is setting, let us enter your gates. Please, havaya ahava Adonai, forgive us, pardon us, have compassion on us, cleanse us, wipe away our misdeeds and our sins.
Turn to 397.
Shelter us beneath the shadow of your hand, beneath the wings of the Shekhinah. Be gracious to us, even as you help us return to a straight path. Stand up for us and give us the strength to stand up for ourselves, for so many people who need an advocate. Let us hear you say, I have forgiven you who dwell beseter Elyon. Use your help to help, use your power to help your downtrodden people. Respond to our pleas with righteousness. Help us draw from your strength. Remember us with boundless loving kindness and infinite compassion. As it is written, for my mountains may vanish and hills may shake and crumble, but my loving kindness will not vanish and my covenant of peace will not be shaken. Thus speaks your God, who has compassion for you. Turn to 398. Eloheinu ve'elohe avoteinu v'imoteinu, selach lanu, machal lanu, kaper lanu.
Ki'anu.
Anu kashe orafatayr chapayim, anu male avonata, male rachamim, anu yamenu kitzel over vatahu shnotenu lo yitamu. We turn to 400. Eloheinu ve'emotenu tavo lefanachat vilatenu. אל תתעלם מתחינתנו שאין אנחנו עזיפנים וכשאורף לומר לפניך We are not so arrogant or stubborn in your presence, Adonai, our God. God of our fathers and our mothers and our grandparents and all our ancestors looking down on us who know our insides. We would not be so arrogant to say Tzadikim anachnu, we are so righteous ולא חטאנו אבל אנחנו חטאנו. However, we have also done good things. This will be the last time that we beat our chests. The moment after this, we'll recall A through Z, Aleph through Taf. Some of the good things we've done as well, they are commingled. But we'll start, of course, with this last vidui. Ay, 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 ay.
Last new,
my heart new.
kishinu oref.
ומשפטיך הטובים ולא שבה לנו אתה צדיק על כל בעלינו כי אמת עשית ואנחנו הרשענו.
So now let's call up all those good things that we did and take a moment. This is back to Rabbi Jeff's question earlier. Maybe let your mind go and think about some of the actually nice things you did for people or for an organization or for an animal, or for the environment, for a stranger, for a person on the street, an act of kindness. Maybe if we mention enough of them, we can amplify them and do more of them in the year to come. So they'll come up on the screen just like this, and we can just read them. I don't know if people on the stage can actually see those small words, but we'll go Hebrew, and then we'll say English.
Ahavnu berachnu gadalnu dibarnu yofi.
We have loved,
we have blessed, we have grown, we have spoken positively. Helinu v'chasnu zaraznu hamalnu chamalnu tapachnu emet.
We have raised up,
we have shown compassion,
we have acted enthusiastically,
we have been empathetic,
we have cultivated truth.
Ay, ay, ay.
Comforted,
we have been creative, we have stirred, we have been spiritual activists,
we have been just,
we have ached for the land. Ay, 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 ay.
We have repaired.
Ay, 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 ay.
Continue on 401.
Manomar lefanecha yoshev marom oman siper lefanecha shochein shechakim. Hello, kol hanistarot hanigloot, ata yoteiha. You know everything that is hidden and everything that is revealed.
What are we? Of what significance are our lives? Of what value are our kindnesses and good deeds? What can we change? What power can we draw on? What can we accomplish?
It's okay.
The sage and Rabbi Mary Oliver, of blessed memory, wrote, "One day, you finally knew what you had to do and began. Though the voices around you kept shouting their bad advice, though the whole house began to tremble and you felt the old tug at your ankles. Mend my life, each voice cried. But you didn't stop. You knew what you had to do. Though the wind pried with its stiff fingers at the very foundations, though their melancholy was terrible. It was already late enough and a wild night and the road full of fallen branches and stones. But little by little, as you left their voices behind, the stars began to burn through the sheets of clouds and there was a new voice, which you slowly recognized as your own, that kept you company as you strode deeper and deeper into the world, determined to do the only thing you could do, determined to save the only life you could save."
Kirov Maseyam Tohu, Pime Chayehem Avalefanacha.
You distinguish human beings from the very start and empower them to stand before you as it is written.
Yazor Ashatakovi Shaven Machshavotav, Veyashov Alanai Verachamehu, Veyalaleinu Ki Arpelisloha. Eloheinu ve'elohe avoteinu, machal avonoteinu, v'yom ha'kippurim hazeh. Mechev aver pesha'einu v'chatoteinu mineged einecha, ka'amor anochi anochi hu, mechev pesha'echa la'amani, l'mani chatotecha, lo ezkor. And it is written, "I will erase your sins like a cloud and your misdeeds like a mist. Turn to me, and I will redeem you." Loeinu veloe avoteinu v'imoteinu kadshenu b'mitzvotecha v'ten chakenu b'toratecha sab'einu mituvecha v'samcheinu yishuatecha v'tahar libeinu le'avdacha be'emet. Tapa 404. Ki atah salchan l'Yisrael v'machalan l'shivtei yishurun v'chol dor v'ador u'mi baladecha ein lanu melech Machel v'soleach ele atah. Baruch atah Adonai, melech mochel v'soleach levonoteinu levonot amo beit Yisrael, umavir ashmoteinu bechol shana v'shana. Melech al kol ha'aretz mekadesh Yisrael. Melech al kol ha'aretz mekadesh Yisrael.
A literal octave over the course of the day. Techazena einenu b'shuva l'tzion barachamim baruch atah Adonai hamachazir shechinato l'tzion. Modim anachnu lach shatah Adonai Eloheinu v'Elohei avoteinu tzur. Shenu atahu l'dor v'dor. No delach alas aper tzitecha. Gather all of our exiles together, so that we together can do your will and serve you wholeheartedly. Hakulam yibarach yivramam shemcha malkeinu tamid lelam ve'ed. Chasala havenu et shemcha be'emet ha'et v'teinu sa. Baruch atah Adonai hatov shemcha u'lecha na'e lehodot.
So
for everybody that was in Devi's Kabbalah for Ne'ila class. Did you guys learn a particular posture this year for how to receive the priestly blessing? So the idea is that the priests, once upon a time, they had, I can only do it on my right hand because I'm, you know, not official. But they had this way of positioning their hands that many think was actually sort of an energy transmitter, and that there was force coming through them that they were transmitting to the people. And Devi teaches us from the mystical tradition that actually if you hold your hands out like a receiver in just the same way, however it is that your fingers congeal in sets of twos, this is the position to receive the priestly blessing in.
Eloheinu ve'elohe avoteinu v'imoteinu barkeinu bevracha ha'meshuleshet batorah hakduva al yedei Moshe avdecha ha'amura mipi aharon vanav kohanim am kedoshecha ka'amur yivarechecha Adonai v'yishmerecha
v'yirasol
ya'er Adonai panav elecha v'yichunecha Yisa Adonai panav elecha v'yasim lecha shalom. May God bless you and watch over you and keep you safe and healthy. May God's light shine on you. May you shine your light in the world. May God raise her face to you. May you see God's face in the face of every person you encounter, and may they look at you and see the face of God, and may you find peace. Ken yehi ratzon.
Ken yehi ratzon.
Sim shalom tova uvracha.
Inscribe us Inscribe us, treat us with goodness. Help us treat each other with goodness.
Avinu Malkeinu Chaneinu
this nigun, we will say the words that close out Yom Kippur officially, and then everything after that is just icing. So listen. Shofar, shofar. Yeah, come on, come on, come on, come on. Let's get all set up here. What we're actually going to do before this is we're going to kind of move these chairs out. Everybody's going to grab their mic and move their mic stands and their chairs so that if you want to actually come up on the Bima, we don't want it too crowded, but if you want to, like, basically rush the stage at the Vic on Yom Kippur so you can say that you did, now is a great time. And we're just going to create some space here. Come on in. Yeah. Come on, come on. Yeah. Teach people this nigun.
Ooh.
גדולה. Take a moment and just capture in your mind something that you heard or saw or felt today. Get a little Kodak moment to hold on to as we say Havdalah, as we make separation between this holy Shabbat Shabbaton and the rest of the year. We need to draw on this strength, this learning, whatever insight we might have had today. So think for a moment. If you want to come up here, I think there's a little more room. We could scooch. There's all these risers and everything. My podium's in the way. We could get in the front of this thing. So feel free. Get cozy. What's our chord for La Yehudim? Just hold it and sing. If you've got that image in your mind or that thing, memory, that little trinket of goodness that you're gonna keep holding on to when you walk out of this place, it's gonna help you a little bit in the coming year be just slightly better than you were when you walked in. So then go like this.
Bye.
Shana Tova.
Shana Tova.
Eliyahu Hanabi. Candle wax in there, she says. It's a David Copperfield style trick. It'll be a mystery forever. If you want to take the candles out when you go, please just turn them off so that some wonderful volunteer doesn't have to turn all of them off for us. We're going to bless this bread and then see everybody who we're going to go see at Ann Sather. Every bite of food you eat tonight, just remember what a gift. Savor this coming year. Yasher Koach, everybody, you did it. Bye. Ruch atah Adonai Eloheinu melech haolam hamotzi lechem min haaretz. Amen. Shana tova. Let's get this one down there, and this one can be up here. Oh, take some. Oh, fine. We'll do more. Here. Who else needs it up here? Anna, take some. Yeah, go ahead.
I've been selling my name for the sake of who knows. I've been trying to explain how it's all gonna go. I don't take my life for granted. I've been waking up tight day after day. Hope it's taking its time to go. Take my life for granted. I'm gonna hold on tight.
granted.